Check this out. Freezing pipes with nitrogen in just 5 minutes. You gotta see it to believe it. Well, it looks like it's at the right temperature now. It's reading 20 ozuntada, while on the other side, it's at 30 da. Hey guys, welcome to this new episode of Aero. Behind me, you can see the heating pipe from an old radiator. I don't need this old radiator connection anymore, so it has to go. These pipes need to be capped off because they're in the way. Usually, you'd locate the shutoff valves, close them, and then you can remove a pipe. But the shutoff valve for this school isn't working anymore. And it's a pretty big school. If I were to drain and refill it, I'd be at it for days. So that's not really an option. However, we can freeze the pipes. There's special equipment for that. You attach clamps to the heating pipes and you end up with a frozen pipe. But today, we're trying something different, a spray can. With this, you can freeze a pipe in just 5 minutes. I'm curious to see how it works. I've used it before on copper pipes, and it worked like a charm. But with heating pipes, I'm eager to see. It's a bit nerve-wracking because if you don't freeze it right and you cut the pipe while the water's flowing, there's no stopping it. So you've got to be prepared for the worst. Before you cut into the heating pipes, you've got to know exactly where to cut. If things go sideways, I can slide this hose over it and direct the water outside. Then it's just waiting for all the water to drain before getting back to work. But let's hope it doesn't come to that. And always have the fitting you're going to use ready. Today I'm using MegaPress, which is super convenient. But I'll also need some threaded adapters. I'm going to prep them with Loctite. The kit comes with zip ties and some extra insulation. This is for a half-inch pipe. They've got a 3/4-inch pipe here, so that's what we'll use. It's easy to connect. And then we hook it up at the top. It comes with 2 zip ties. Next, I'm drilling a small hole to introduce some nitrogen. If liquid nitrogen starts spewing out the sides, you've got to stop. Wait for about 5 minutes, and then it's cutting time. Here's where it gets tense. Now I can fit the ball valve and test it. It's all straightforward if you know what you're doing. We're going to freeze the second pipe with this neat device. It's actually pretty simple. You apply a conducting gel to the exterior clamps, and you clamp them onto the heating pipes. After that, it's a waiting game. Once my pipe reaches below 22.2 degree, I know the ice plug has formed, and I can calmly cut the pipe. But before I do, I'm going to run a check. Looking at it now, it seems to be at the right temperature. It's at 22 degree, and on the other side, it's 30 degree, so I'm confident we've got an ice plug. I'll now turn on the water on the other side to test if it's truly frozen, and then we can cut the pipe. Simple as that, and no water's coming out. We're good to go. Let's do this. The biggest perk of such a device is the peace of mind it provides. As long as it's on, everything stays cool, and that's a wrap.
Deze losmaken. Zo.
I've dropped a link in the description for the materials I used. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more useful tips and tutorials. Give us a thumbs up and let us know your thoughts in the comments below. See you next time.